It is time once again for The Adventures of Damsel Doggy. Da, 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 da. Starring Brian and a Viking helmet. As usual, I did a warm up before today's daily. Got to the jungle. I'd somehow managed to spend all of my ropes, and so I was hoping to practice a no rope black market robbery. But at the end of 2-1, there is an interesting set of shopkeepers in a market that included a freeze ray, and somehow while battling the shopkeepers, one of the shopkeepers managed to pick up the freeze ray gun and hit me with the freeze ray gun and then toss my frozen ice cube body, shattering me into 1,000 pieces. And so that's how things ended for me during the warm-up. But I still felt like I was playing okay, so hopefully today's daily will go reasonably well. I should be well-rested, which I'll explain the questioning tone of my voice in a moment. Okay, good. Oh, hey, that worked out super cool. Can I kill a skeleton with a skeleton? Oh, wow. I'm on fire. Look out, world. Yeah, I should be well-rested because I took a nap this afternoon. I got up today and I was just really tired for some reason. And so I ended up going back to bed. Why am I so tired? Maybe it's a tumor. It's not a tumor. yeah, I don't know if I was a little under the weather or I just didn't sleep well or whatever. But yeah, went back to bed, got some more rest. Hopefully that'll help. Let's go ahead and break this. Damsel Doggy is gonna cost us a bomb? One bomb and some risk would be enough, but I am unwilling to spend it. I'm sorry, Damsel Doggy, we're gonna have to leave you behind today here on 1-1, and we will move forward and hope for better things on 1-2. Yeah, so in any case, I'm more well-rested now, but as a result, I feel behind. Oop, that's not what I meant to do. I was trying to, Should I go after that gem? Should I spend a rope on that gem? Need to worry about the arrow trap that's over there. Actually, will the arrow destroy the gem? I'm not even sure. You would think I would know most of the things about this game by now. You would think. But it's dangerous to think things. Alright, what do we got over here? Yeah, this is worth robbing. Sorry, shopkeeper. The pick by itself makes it worth robbing this shop. Let's see, just because it can be so valuable, I need to toss it downwards. I don't have the Eye of Ujjat yet, which is always a danger. And actually, I should have gone ahead and gotten that spider coming down, probably. And did I just leave the pick behind? Yeah. Alright, well guess what? We're gonna go back up. And we're gonna correct a couple of errors that I've already made, in my own opinion. Which include, one, we should do this, we'll get some money, and we'll get the spider jumping around. The spider may, in fact, jump onto some spikes down there. I'm unclear whether the spikes are kind of available for the spider to jump on yet or not. And two, oh, whoa, hey! Hey, ho, ho, hey, ho, whoa. Let's go ahead and drop that on your head, too. Do a little bit more damage. And two, we'll get some of the gold that I've left behind up here, because it's the one thing that we can actually kind of like see in the walls at this moment in time, since we don't have the spectacles of the Eye of Ujjat. And so that is what I'm trying to get out of the pick in terms of extra money. The pick is super cool. All right, we got a dog over here. Where did Big Spider go? He's way down here. I think actually should be able to get him right here or over here. Scary moment. Crap. There we go. Okay, great. Okay, so I've got a shotgun at the exit, which is terrific. We have a damsel doggy that... Did I just leave damsel doggy behind up there? I did. I'm gonna spend another rope. This is not the best use of ropes that I've ever spent in my spelunky career. That's okay. We do the things we need to do. The ghost is gonna be coming from... I would like the ghost to come from the left, but I also need to hurry up and run over here and get the gold that I'm trying to go after. And possibly the pick to get a little bit of extra gold. No! Oh my gosh! I'm such a dummy. Oh, that is embarrassing. Well, better today than on a day when I was dueling someone. View the leaderboard. Well, I feel good that most people have died in mines. That felt like a promising daily to me, actually. I wonder if Jay Sano will manage to go all the way to Yama. That's my guess. It's a crazy, wild, random guess, not having seen much of the level. I think we need to play a little bit of adventure mode after this. Here is kind of like how things finished up. I think possibly all these scores were already there yesterday, because when Cthulhu and I had our little duel, it was at the end of the day. And so, let me fire up adventure mode and see if we can have some more fun. And let's see. I'm actually going to try, once again, not again kind of a speed run, but just a Brian moving faster than he normally does run in an attempt to change my game skills. The walls are shifting.
Ooh.
Leaning into the microphone for the ooh. Alright, and so since I'm not going to go for like all the money and everything, we're going to try to move quickly. I see the damsel here, so I'm going to take him. It looks like it's going to dead end this way, so I think I actually need to go this way. Nope, I was wrong. I needed to go that way. So I need to learn my level layouts better. Damsel doggy managed to just glide over the spikes, which is perfect, because it would have been a real tragedy if damsel doggy died due to my own carelessness and hurry. Didn't I see a crate over here somewhere? I did see a crate over here. Can I get to this crate? Not without spending a bomb. However, the bomb that I spend will also get a fair amount of gold. And so I'm willing to spend that bomb to get all of that gold and get to the crate and all the money that's over here. And the answer is ropes. Okay, so we have some extra ropes. Go pick up some of the other gold that I managed to bomb out of here. And I've already seen where the exit is, I believe. Let's go ahead and collect a little bit more money along the way. And I will pick up a skull, oops, to carry forward to the next level. And yeah, a minute. That's pretty good in terms of Brian time. I'm trying to improve my ability to make split-second decisions, even if they're not always correct. And yeah, hope that it's going to aid me in the long run. And you know what? Excuse me. We're gonna have to do that. Just because... Oh boy! That is not what I wanted. Phew! That could have gone much worse. And actually, this is a pretty vertical turning level, and so I think we're gonna get to the exit fairly quickly, except for I just... left behind. I kinda need to practice... Well, I could use the shotgun for a light, too. That's another thing I can practice, is getting by a dark level without a light source when I've got the shotgun. But I also need to practice climbing down into the spikes, either by using a rope. I've got extra ropes, actually. Maybe I should do that. Let's do that. I totally need to practice this. And since we're doing some adventure mode, okay, so if you put a rope here, then I believe you can climb down, yes. I can pick this thing up, and then I can get out of here. Great. All right. And then, so long as I'm doing that, I was supposed to be hurrying, but I'm also going to just add some light to the level so I can see if there's anything else important that I missed, such as the crate up here, which, now that I have extra ropes, it's totally worth a rope. More ropes! Alright. So, we are rope-tastic, we are rope-erific, we are rope-a-doodle-doo. I'm not sure what other crazy words with ropes that we are, but if there are any, trust me, I'm all over that. Okay, great. Let's go grab our shotgun and run to the exit and continue to the next level. I missed Damsel Doggy somewhere along the way. Sorry, Damsel Doggy. That money was too easy to pass up. I do see that there's another pot there. Oh well. Okay, so I got to practice something new, using a rope to climb down onto spikes. And I was rewarded with the easiest Eye of Ujat rescue there ever was, right at the beginning of 1-3. So good for me. And now, since I've got the ropes, I will do that. I probably... That would have been a good opportunity to practice whipping the arrow, because you can always just use your whip to get past arrow traps, and when you see expert speedrunners at Spelunky, that's basically all they do. They just, like, run through the mines, and it looks like they're completely ignoring the arrow traps, but in fact, they are somehow seeing and detecting all the arrow traps so quickly that they can fire their whip at just the right moment in order to have the whip knock the arrows right out of the sky, and every time I see it happen, I'm like, holy crap, how is anybody that good at this game? Whoa, okay, I do want to rescue the damsel. I do have the shotgun, which I could have used for a shotgun jump, but I also just need to practice jumping across three wide gaps just like that. We're practicing all kinds of things here in Adventure Mode, which is kind of the reason that I wanted to play. I haven't been playing much Adventure Mode when I have poor runs. I've been tending to just either have very short episodes or else not air them at all. Oh! Damsel Doggy! I shot Damsel Doggy. That's awful. But I realized that there's a number of things that I need to practice, and I'm usually unwilling to kind of like take... Alright, I'm getting really sloppy here. Take the risks to practice them during the daily, and so a little bit of Adventure Mode play is exactly what the doctor ordered. Another thing that I need to do is not completely forget about the fact that there's shopkeepers right at the exit, and accidentally almost run into them. And that gold is too easy to pass up. Okay, great. So yeah, this is going to go kind of fast and loose, and I'll just be practicing a few things, and hopefully I'll learn something useful along the way. And if we do well, then that's great, and if we don't do well, that's okay too. There's a freeze ray down there. Don't really need that. There is a wild shopkeeper over here who... What's the best way to take care of this guy? I think I can totally do this, actually. Gonna work on the timing. One, two. Nope, got it wrong. Oh no, I did get him! Hooray! Okay. And, I've got seven ropes. Yeah, let's do this. We are gonna get the shopkeeper up to the Kali altar. I know this isn't super fast, but this is another thing that I just need to practice in general, which is moving quickly. Okay, while making sacrifices, because given my own personal rule that we don't sacrifice Damsel Doggy, it's made it very difficult for me to ever obtain the Kali altar or various Kali gifts. And so I'm really trying to work on playing quickly enough that I can just get shopkeepers and cavemen and all the various corpses that I do have available to me. Oops, that was wrong. All right, that was really lucky, but I will take it. You know what? Let's do this too. We got some time left on the clock. And where is the best place? I believe right here. And I think that's all the ropes I'm going to need. Yes, so we'll be able to get this shopkeeper corpse up to the Kali altar as well. Trying to jump up the ropes in order to speed things up as much as possible. That is not enough sacrificing to get a gift. And so once I drop him on the Kali altar, I immediately depart. And there could be a crate over here, and so I at least need to take a look. There's a damsel over here! We can redeem ourselves for having shot Damsel Doggy on the last level, and we can save Damsel Doggy on this level. Hooray! Okay, and I already had two shotguns over here, and so I wasted time. I guess I might have been able to use a shotgun jump to get up to Damsel Doggy and not spend a rope there, but it didn't occur to me soon enough. Alright, but we did all that, and we still had 20 more seconds before the ghost was gonna come. So, while I'm definitely, you know, leaving some cash on the table or leaving some other things behind or out of the picture, I'm happy with the fact that I'm at least continuing to stay alive, despite the fact that I'm moving more quickly than I typically do. There's a tiny chance that I am going to be missing the black market in the top left corner. No, I'm pretty sure it is not there. So we'll continue to move forward. Because that's another thing I need practice with, is just continuing to move quickly through the jungle. I've gone through all my bombs somehow along the way. That could be a problem. That could definitely be a problem. Well, we'll wait until we actually see the black market to worry about it. Although, no, we should be worried about it from the point of view, from the perspective of if we happen to see, we happen to see an orange frog, we should try to preserve him until such moments as we are ready to put him to use as a black market opener finder thingy. Go ahead and get this bat over here. I forgot if this is going to be hitting the shopkeeper already. Sounds like no. I'm pretty sure I can get the piranha like that. Getting a little bit better at the piranhas. I haven't had much chance to practice them, but I've kind of watched some other people play against the piranha. And the shopkeeper over here is going to be a real challenge. In fact, without bombs, I think what I need to do... Oh, alright. I think that's going to be the right thing to do, though, is hit him once that way to get him angry, and then take a step back. So get ready, get ready, get ready. Crap! Oh, I'm in so much trouble. Crap. Jump. Jump into my bullets, you crazy shopkeeper. Yeah, I kind of like standing here, actually. Alright, that felt good, but sadly, it doesn't seem to be making any progress. Oh no! I'm back down here. Crap! Alright. Time to own up to the fact that if we're not going to take some risks, we are not going to manage to kill that shopkeeper. Guess what? I managed to kill that shopkeeper. And this guy. Damsel doggy, you're worth a rescue. Crap! Oh boy! Let's do it, let's do it! Yes! Yes, yes, yes. For those of you still watching, wasn't this episode worth it? Wasn't it worth coming along, even though it was just adventure mode and practice, just to see that amazing little bit right there? I believe the answer you're looking for is yes. All right, Black Markets is somewhere below me. I didn't see where it was. I've not yet seen an orange frog or a crate with a pick or bombs that might help me out. So we're going to continue to stand the level. Okay, there's a crate, but I can't get to that crate. There's another crate over here. Please have something good. Ropes. I should have been more specific. All right, Black Market's got to be right down here somewhere. Whoa! Ouch, ouch, ouch. Why do I still not see it? Gotten a couple of ticks already. Oh gosh, it's like down below that tree, isn't it? It's invisible. I have spike shoes. Let's see, this guy, he's just gonna give me extra shoes. Hooray, extra shoes, which will give me extra jumping abilities, and so maybe somehow, unless there's bombs further on in the level, I don't see myself getting to the black market, sadly. Okay, let's go ahead and get past here. These guys are going to cause trouble, so we'll leave them behind. Need to move swiftly anyway, if I have any chance at anything here. Oh, goodness. Alright, let's take out the bats, then let's take out the frog. Let's not worry about the piranha plant. Let's do worry about the shopkeeper, who's right here. Oh, boy. I have done something bad. Shoo! Let's practice this again. Because I definitely need to practice. Hooray! That is how you get money off of spikes. Alright, we're totally learning things. Alright, so we're gonna miss the black market because I don't see any way, I don't see any kind of explosives or picks or anything that I could use to get to the black market. And so we'll just play out this adventure run and see how it goes. Perhaps we'll have the opportunity to practice more things. And yeah, it's at least giving me some confidence. Like, I tend to play, like, shopkeepers. Well, I've been getting a little bit more crazy with some of my play, but I tend to try to play things pretty conservatively during the daily. And I definitely, whoa, okay. Definitely feel like I'm taking more risks here in adventure mode, and actually a non-trivial number of those risks are paying off for me, and so I'm kind of happy about that. I'm about to leave the damsel behind. I think I am gonna go down this way, and so I'm gonna leave the shotgun there, just in case there happens to be a Kali altar on the bottom. I'm also going to try to get that corpse down there, and then was the damsel gettable? I don't remember. So let's go see. Are you gettable, damsel doggy? You are totally gettable. Oh, there's a shop over there that contains a shotgun, and what else does it have? Let's go take a quick look. I believe if I bend down over here... Eh, mystery gift, angry shopkeeper. Yeah, I don't know that we want to go there. We will leave that behind. And focus on the good things in life, such as an adorable damsel pug. And I will get that money, even though it's taking some time. All right, damsel doggy can be safely dropped down over there. I don't think I need this corpse, but I'm gonna drop it down over here as well. And all right, we have shopkeepers, okay, who are alive on the level above me, but I don't think they're gonna come into play down here. We got a crate. Can't wait to see what's in this crate. More ropes. Just really hoping for something other than ropes. Here's the shopkeeper. I think if I get him angry... Can I get him angry? Oh, dear. What do I do here, folks? I know what I do. I do... Yup! Yup! Okay. Then I go... Yup! 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 Okay. This is good. This is actually good. He might injure himself on the tiki traps. I think I should hang around here for a moment. I could also throw rocks at him. Oh, he took some damage. I can throw rocks at him. I can throw the boomerang at him. How much time do I have? I have 20 more seconds. I'm gonna need to go fetch the damsel. Okay. He at least gave me a chance to run over here. And leave that behind for the moment. There we go. Okay, he's dead. Great. Let's go get the damsel. There'll be a shotgun down where his corpse is. And I'm gonna get the ghost to come from the right-hand side of the screen. And so let's just wait here for 28, 29, 30. We got the ghost coming. And that's also the first time I believe that the ghost has made an appearance. Because I actually have been moving faster than usual, so that's terrific. Whoa! Okay, I managed to not completely screw that up, and so that is terrific. Look at this! Staying alive, getting gold, killing shopkeepers, no bombs. It's like I know how to play this game. This is the guy who died on 1-3 or whatever in the actual daily. Oh boy, I do like these jumpy boots. I like having the extra vertical mobility. In general, I think vertical mobility power-ups are extremely powerful and important in this game. All right, so we're gonna grab the shotgun. We're gonna see if we can, oh boy, not fall on spikes. Oh, oh, or fall into a tiki trap. All right. Man, even some spectacles would help at this point. Bombs! Apparently, once I finally wish for something other than bombs, I get the bombs. Thanks a lot, game. Ooh, I hear bees, I believe. Alright, I can see where I can jump down safely over there. Whoa, I almost just jumped on those spikes even though I knew they were there. Forgot about them for a moment. Alright, so I'm pretty sure... Oops, crap. Alright, I can... Let's do this. Let's jump over here. Let's fall down and grab the shotgun. I thought I heard bees, but now I'm not so sure. I don't have a compass, so... Oh boy, guess what? Found the exit. This looks like it's going to be difficult. There are bats directly below me who are causing the top tiki trap to not fire at the shopkeeper. I wonder if I can take out the bats somehow here. I don't think I'm going to be able to do that. Let's try... I think this is going to be a make a run for it. Oh, well that worked. Alright, now I can just drop down and then press the spacebar. And by the spacebar, I mean the number 4 key on my controller, because I use Joy to Key to map my random knockoff PS4 controller to the keyboard controls. But hey, it worked. Okay. Let's see. I'm in the ice caves, the only vertical mobility, at least I have spike shoes. So that is useful for not sliding around on the ice. But I do not have, other than the jumpy boots, much vertical mobility. And we talked about how important that is, especially so in the ice caves. If I had climbing gloves or something I could get up there, I guess I could. Let's see if we can manage to get back up there at the end and actually get the idol, because it's worth a lot of money. And I know I was originally, like, trying to do things quickly, but now I'm just more... Like, once I get this far, like, I could always just use more ice caves practice, especially with different sets of power-ups and things. And so any practice I can get is probably good. Not trying to ghost, I'm just trying to, oh, crap. Well, obviously not, hopefully. Alright, I do have spike shoes, so I can just jump on your head. Still have some hearts. Haven't figured out where the exit is yet. Is it right down here? It is right down here. What is the best way to deal with that shopkeeper? It is to throw a landmine at him, I think, probably. And so let's go find a landmine that we can pick up somewhere. If such a thing exists. Yeah, let's try this. There's a landmine, great.
Phew.
Okay, picked it up. I made this jump over, did I make that jump? No, I made the lower jump, didn't I? Can I make that jump? With the jumpy shoes, can I jump up here? No. I think it might be time to use a rope. Let's regain some mobility. That'll also help get us to Damsel Doggy. Okay, and now... This is still gonna be tough. Oh no, that'll work. Hi, shopkeeper. Bye, shopkeeper. Great. All right, and now whatever I did over here should still work. Great, can pick this back up because I think the shopkeeper's gun may have fallen into the void, and so I think I'm going to need to preserve my own gun. We're running low on time, so I will drop that off over here. We'll do one more cycle around. We will grab the damsel because it's the Adventures of Damsel Dog. Even in adventure mode, the damsel is still important to us. Also because I could use the hearts. And oh, he left his gun. That was a very nice shopkeeper. I don't even need to go get my own gun. All right, good enough. Since I haven't been to the black market, I do not have the Ankh, which means no Moai head intentional deaths for Brian today. And yeah, since I'm trying to just kind of practice and move quickly and not worry about all the money, I forgot to ever try to go back for the that thing on the previous level. Didn't think about possibly trying to use the jumpy things for extra vertical mobility here in the ice caves. Like, I rarely use them intentionally, like I usually see them as threats. And I do have 3 bombs, I need to not completely forget about that as well. Alright, let's go ahead and shoot that guy. And there's a landmine over here that I think I would like to pick up and have available for whatever things I'm gonna go after next. Okay, I still have 4 ropes, so I'm not too worried about losing my verticality. And I think actually a drop will work here. Nope, I was wrong. I guess next time we will try a throw.
Yep. Heep. Nope. Hoop. Heep. Hope.
All right, I think if I throw this, it's gonna bounce. And so I think that's not gonna work either. Maybe if I drop it, okay, gently from right here. I actually don't think that's gonna work either. What if I drop it from here? Here we go. There we go. That, my friends, is how you kill a shopkeeper. I don't see a Kali altar or anything else too exciting. All right, Damsel Doggy was like up here somewhere. I think I can get up to Damsel Doggy without needing to use another rope. If I go kind of a crazy way. Oh, except right here, even with a shotgun jump, I don't think I'm gonna get him, so we'll continue to try to rescue the damsel, because Adventures of Damsel Dog, you've been over this. Shopkeeper's corpse, I think, will actually still be here. Corpse. Shotgun will still be here, and so we'll take that forward. And see what we can do. And so even without trying very hard for getting all the gold or ghosting anything, like, if you get this far along, like, you tend to just accumulate a decent score. And so I'm already broken 100,000, which at this point is not enough to, if this were the daily, like, raise my all-time top 10 daily. But it at least goes to prove that staying alive and getting far is kind of a perfectly reasonable strategy in and of itself when it comes to trying to get a decent score. I'm not sure where to go, and I think we're gonna have to bring the dog somewhere. Can I do, if I drop, oops, crap. Well, my gun fell somewhere. I'm not sure where it fell. Oh, Damsel Doggy! Oh, can I catch Damsel Doggy in midair? No. What do I do here? Damsel Doggy, hopefully you fell with the gun. Hopefully the two of you are safe together. Well, there's the gun. All right, I do have spike shoes, so I can do, oh crap. Well, this'll work too. Damsel Doggy, are you down? Oh no. Damsel Doggy has fallen out of the world. Let us take a moment to mourn the loss of Damsel Doggy. He was a cute little bug who deserved better. Not sure what to do here. We're gonna try doing this. Get better eyes on the shopkeeper. I'm pretty sure I can just take him on. Oh. Hey, shopkeeper. Hi-ya! He didn't see me, really? Let's just wake him up. Even caught some of the gold. That was just born out of frustration. Mostly losing the damsel. It kind of worked. Felt like it was a waste of a bomb. But here we are, still alive. You know what I need to practice? I need to practice the mothership. Even with the lack of vertical mobility power-ups that I have, I've got the jumpy boots. I've only got two bombs. I've only got two ropes. That's not a great... Oop! Well, now I'm dead. So much for the mothership. All right. We got a fair amount of good practice in there. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. I hope that you guys are having a great day, and I will see you again soon for more The Adventures of Damsel Doggy. And for those of you who love Minecraft Bingo, keep your eyes peeled on the channel over the next day or so. Bye-bye.